Okay, everyone, we are back with some more Shining Force 2. I went ahead and I did a little bit of training. I got everyone up to level 4. I figured that if I got everyone up to level 4 like this, then we probably wouldn't have to do any more training, really, for a long time. These levels will carry us pretty much through for a very long time. I just wanted to get a little beefed up. Also, I wanted to talk to this homeboy right here. So this old man knew Bowie's father, and apparently he was a great leader. Very interesting. I wonder who Bowie's father could be. And of course, Bowie's mother doesn't have a goddamn thing to say, except, your father would have been proud. Alright, time to bizounce out of here, and get on to this battle. We got a bunch of rats and ooze to kill. Okay, so yeah, this is quite an easy battle, actually. We just got that ooze chilling up top, and then there's just a couple more oozes and rats. We'll just go ahead and send Chester up here, and he should be able to take this fucker out by himself. Yeah, he's not gonna struggle too hard over here. And our boy Jaha is very powerful. We'll put Jaha right here, it's fine. Jaha is gonna be very useful. We actually probably will take him the entirety of the game with us. There's a pretty good chance of it. Alright, so the rat's going for Sarah, but it's no big deal. The main reason I got everyone up to level 4 was basically to baby Sarah along. Sometimes, if you're not doing a lot of grinding, Sarah can really fall behind. And if you don't use every single point of magic, then she can really lag behind. So I just made sure to get her on an equal playing field with everyone else. And so much for that ooze, he could suck a big cock. Damn, Chester got 49 experience for that, huh? Not bad, not bad. Okay, we definitely want to take out this rat first. These rats are quite a bit stronger than the ooze. And Sarah, she doesn't need to heal. Let's just have her smack the rat. 3? Eh, whatever. Okay, Jaha. Yeah, let's get rid of this rat. So here's our first look at Jaha. And 7. Not bad, not bad. I believe Jaha has our highest attack right now. Let me double check. As soon as these dumbasses get done with their turns. Going for Bowie. I'll have Sarah heal him then. Okay, so Chester has 14 attack. Bowie has 15. And Jaha has 17. Yeah, so he's a little bit tougher, alright. And let's go ahead and have Chester start working on this guy up here. Oh boy. Bowie, go ahead and take this guy. Let's come take this ooze out right here. Very nice. I almost feel like going up to level 4 was a bit too much, but we're still getting 49 experience, so it's not that bad. Sarah learned detox, by the way. But yeah, she has detox level 1, which is good for healing poison, but it's not really that essential. You could just go to a priest and have them do it. Most of the time, that's easier than using detox. Especially this early in the game where we've only got one healer. We don't really want to waste her MP using detox. We'd like to have it being saved for heals and shit. Let's see if Jaha can one-shot the suit. Nope. Leveled up, though. Ooh, HP 2. I'll take it. and defense too. So early on, he's becoming a huge tank. That's nice. And I think I'm gonna let Sarah get this kill here. I really wish Bowie had higher defense too. God damn it. Let's just ease a little bit closer. Bowie doesn't need the kill. We'll let Sarah get it. Bye out, bitch. So Sarah's still doing 5 too. That's not bad. The level ups here in Shining Force 1 are a lot more static than they were in Shining Force, level ups in Shining Force 2 are a lot more static than level ups in Shining Force 1. If you remember in Shining Force 1, we would get random level ups. Sometimes we would just get health plus 5, or attack 2, defense 1, health 1. Like, the level ups were mostly seemingly randomized. But in Shining Force 2, most of the time you'll pretty much just get 1 to every stat. That more or less is how it works. Like, we saw that Jaha got, like, 2 health, you know, and you'll see, you know, 2 attack, or Bowie will randomly gain MP or something like that. But level ups are pretty much standardized, really. Chester will go ahead and take this guy out. In Shining Force 3, when you're unpromoted, your levels are actually kind of randomized. Not quite as much as Shining Force 1, but more so than here in Shining Force 2. It's interesting, the promotion mechanic is so much different in all three games. It's not the same in any of them. So every time you start a new Shining Force, you're kind of starting over fresh. And I think I'm actually going to give this kill to Sarah again. She needs it. Yeah. We're gonna give it to Sarah. And I'm gonna have Bowie chill on that land effect 30 in case Sarah can't get the job done. Alright, but she did. Cool, cool. So yeah, that battle is ridiculously easy. Nothing, too greatly hard there. And we can get a good look at Grand Seal from the outside. There's the ancient tower sticking up out of that mountain. Okay. But now we are going to head down here. And there's something right here. More mithril. There's 15 pieces of mithril in the game, and we're just going to keep finding them scattered all over the place. We'll give it to Jaha. And let's jump in here. Oh yeah, we got some shrine music. I'm loving this. And quickly, you see exactly where we are. This is where Slade got those 2 jewels out in the intro. This chest, we can't get into this chest till later. But there actually is a okay piece of equipment in there. I probably won't use it though. And we can go ahead and grab this power water that Slade left us. Thank you very much, Slade, you good old chap. And nothing. So it's an interesting little area. We can just come grab the power water and then we could be outie. Time to head to Yeel. We gotta go find our homeboy Howl, see what's up with him. And hold on, let me take a look at the inventory again real quick. So we'll probably just sell off the Angel Wing, I guess. Yeah, so let's give the Power Water over to Sarah. And we'll have her sell the Angel Wing in Yeel. The next town we're headed to. I think we actually can go up here. But the bridge is not down for Galam, so we can't actually head into town. And there's no secrets around here or anything. they don't lower the drawbridge until later on. And later on, there's also a area right here that's important. But nothing there as of right now. Enough playing around, on with the story, goddammit. So what's up? Yes, you. I figured that. Healing seed. Not bad, not bad. So that means we could sell a medical herb then. Oh, every single character's dialogue, they're just asking for it. Oh, fuck peace, man. I'm so bored. That's not what they're gonna be saying soon. And more fucking chickens and hens and shit all over the place. Oh, so it is a hen. I was right. Yep. Oh, Galam soldiers asking where Howl lives, huh? Just an old man. There you go. Kind of a screwball. Northwest of the village. Okie dokie. And we got a piano here. That'll come into play way later on. Oh yeah, we already talked to this bitch. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. Need armor. Who on our team has armor on? Chester, I guess. Mr. Lemon. Leader of the Glom army. And his name is in all caps. Just pointing that out to everyone. Apparently he's really cute. And you've got nothing to add to that? Yeah, you're a big fan of Mr. Lemon. I'm sure you'll remain that way for the rest of the game. He said, do you know him? But he didn't even... Okay, so interesting. He's blocking off whatever this note is. What do these books say? Ecology, alright. Civilizations. So nothing of any great importance. This is an extremely boring village. There's nothing going on. But there's a cat in here with the priest for some reason. What's up, cat? Nothing. Alright, what's up, girl? Okay, Kazen. So this good old fellow's name is Kazen, even though he didn't tell us that. Off to go see him. And boom, we are thrust into another battle. This battle is not tough. Again, there's nothing really spectacular. We just have a couple enemies on our way over to Howl's house. Oozes, rats, the same old shit. Here's Howl's house right here. There is one guy down here. The huge bat. Now, if you remember in Shining Force 1, the reason these guys were so annoying was because they would evade like crazy. Well, here in Shining Force 2, the big annoyance with them is they could put you to sleep, which is a huge fucking pain in the ass. Alright, so let's just get going with this battle and start wiping these scrubs out. Chester, fuck them up. Seven, that's decent. Alright, Sarah, just move forward, whatever. Cool, Bowie can kill this guy and catch up to everyone else at level 5. All ones, nothing out of the ordinary there. Going for Chester? That's so weird. Alright. It's strange. They seem to be going for Chester an awful lot. They're even bypassing shots at Bowie to do so. Uh, Sarah, let's just have you smack the rat. 2 points of damage on Chester isn't really anything too ridiculous. And Chester, go ahead and smack this fuckboy. Got him down to one, huh? Not bad. Probably the one big problem with Shining Force 2 as compared to Shining Force 1 is that there is an amazing amount of filler battles. And what I mean by filler battles, I'm talking about this battle and the last one we just did, where all we're doing is running across these fields fighting fucking ooze and giant rats. You know, there's no unique enemies or bosses or even humans we're fighting. Whereas in Shining Force 1, most of the battles had, you know, something going on. So Chester, ooh, health too. And defense too. Chester's got some good growths going on early here. And we can go ahead and heal him now. In Shining Force 1, I believe there is 30 storyline battles. Battle 1 being the shrine outside of Guardiana, and Battle 30 being the battle with Dark Dragon. And I believe here in Shining Force 2, there is 45 storyline battles. So, there is a significantly higher amount. It's just a lot of them happen to be filler. I would like to use this medical herb, but we'll save it for the next fight. Actually, we're just gonna use it. Medical herb away. Why not? We need space cleared up. I'm waiting for this giant bat. Come on, cocksucker. He's just lining up with us. Whatever. Let's send Chester to go get rid of that ooze. And Bowie and Jaha, we're gonna go take down this fucking giant bat down here. Meanwhile, I'm just gonna have Sarah just pepper us with heals. Jaha. Waiting for this goddamn bat any day now. Going for Sarah. Ooh, he did 5, and Sarah's asleep. Well, that's a goddamn shame, huh? Good thing Bowie and Jaha will be able to double-team his ass. So we can take him out before he can do any more damage. Okay, yeah, let's get rid of him now. Seven, decent. And Jaha. Fuck you, bitch. Oh, we got another medical herb, great. I'm so happy for that. Sarah woke up, that's cool. God, these enemies are such trash. I wonder if any of these other fuckboys have any items on them. Doesn't look like it. So we'll have Chester take the zoos out, and then we'll have Jaha and Bowie. And I guess maybe Sarah triple team this rat down here. Sure, why not? She'll probably gain more experience by hitting it than healing anyway. Nope, same amount. And there we go, that's battle 3 down. Ooh, health too. Very nice, Bowie. That's exactly what the fuck I like seeing. Okay, so let's head on to Howl's house now. Oh shit, what do we have going on in here? They're just bouncing. See you later, fucker. Kazen. Oh man, we got the sad theme now? Oh shit. They demanded his notes on Ground Seal, otherwise known as the Ancient Tower. Ooh, Bowie with a line of dialogue. That's very rare. The Ancient Seal. Well, we know who broke the Ancient Seal. It was Slade, the fucking thief. They couldn't stop telling us, Slade the thief opens the chest. Slade the thief grabs the jewels. Grand's Island is lost. Alright, so he's talking about the jewels, but we already could gather that much. And he fades away. Goodbye, Sir Howl. Yes, it is, indeed. Alright, Kazen, let's fuck up these devils together. Yeah, he joins right as we bro fists and everything. Kazen the Mage. Let's go to the Ancient Shrine. That's where we just got the power water. Okay, so Kazen joined our team. That's pretty fucking sweet. He basically is the equivalent of Tao, as you can tell by his blaze level 1. Let's grab these two chests over here while we can. Antidote? Ugh, garbage. That's fucking trash. Healing drop. Now that's not trash. We'll hold on to that for a long time, actually. Great. Inventory management. Here we go. Alright, we're dropping the antidote. We don't need it. Goodbye. And let's go ahead and drop the angel wing as well. Money is not going to be a problem because, again, I'm planning on going through this with no debts. Oh, yeah. I didn't originally think about that, but we beat Shining Force 1 with no deaths, so let's do Shining Force 2 as well. I want everyone to have at least one open slot. So let's give this healing drop over to Kazen. And there's no reason to get rid of this one Jaha has. Let's just give it over to Sarah. And we'll have her use it in the next battle. Because the next battle actually gets a little tougher than what we've faced so far. Okay, so we're looking good. And what do all these shelves have to say? Diary? Nothing. History of Grands. The Ground Seal. Okay. Sacred War. Nothing is really catching our eye here. Living Alone. Oh, that's sad. Study of the Tower. Mountains. Villages. Alright, so there's some random ass shit in there. And a deep and dirty well. Okay, let's go. And looks like the Galam soldiers are waiting for us. Galam soldiers! Damn, that's... why do you have to be such a dick? Grand Seal scum, fuck you. How could you be so mean? So we can learn the truth! Let's do it! Capture them alive. Okay, here we go. So now we have a fun battle here. Let's go ahead and pop open the map. And you can see there's a significant amount of enemies here. And we got a bunch of new ones. The Galam Soldier, 15 attack. That's pretty high. The Bat also has 15 attack. And we got a Galam Archer. He also has 15 attack. Okay. But there's a whole bunch of dudes here. But we now have Kazan, our boy, who was able to fuck shit up. So we ain't scared. Sarah, just stand right there, whatever, who gives a shit. Just as long as we keep Kazan away from taking shots, we'll be fine. Ooh, a second attack. And there he goes for Oh, do not put him asleep. Oh, thank God. Oh my God, fuck. See, the giant bats, their goal is to just fucking pester me to no end. Putting Kazan to sleep, motherfuckers. Alright, let's take out the bat first. Oh, Jesus. I'm having serious deja vu. And Kazan didn't wake up, great. Okay, Bowie. Fuck. We'll have Jaha attack the bat. We'll have Bowie go for the soldier. Oh, shit. We gotta heal Kazan, too. And Sarah. We are going to have Sarah heal Kazan. Pain in my dick, stupid giant bats, man. Alright, cool. Sarah got a level up. I love it. Oh my god. Now this fucker's going for Kazan again. Jaha, we're gonna have him heal Kazan. Fuck you. Keep attacking Kazan. I'm just gonna keep healing him, you cockboy. Yeah, you like that? And the huge bat gets a second attack, the fucker. Jesus Christ. These dudes are getting some insane luck right now. They're just procking me to death. Alright, let's take out the Galam soldier. Since the huge bat just went. Alright, Bowie, go ahead and take his ass down. Fuck you, bro. Alright, Kazan woke up, fucking finally. And let's go ahead and heal Kazan now. Don't want him dying. All the luck in the world is not gonna save you, Galam scumbags. Fuck you all. So here comes the bat, gonna put Kazan asleep again. Oh, thank God. Jesus Christ, this is nuts. Just go ahead and stand right here and hit it. Ooh, Jaha leveling up, very nice. Alright, cool. This fucking bat is dead. Finally! So let's just chill. As we can see, the main danger is the giant bats, just from putting us to sleep. So let's have Sarah start doing a little healing. There we go. So this archer's closing in. He thinks he's gonna be a badass, but we're gonna fuck him up. I think I'm gonna give this medical herb to Sarah. I am. I'll let her have all the medical herbs pretty much since she gains 10 experience from using them. Whereas everyone else only gains one. And let's have Bowie stand in this 30% land effect. Start working on this archer over here. He has pretty good defense. Wow. And we'll put Sarah right here. And let's have her use this medical herb. She is just gaining experience like nuts. Kazen, go ahead and throw some blaze in this guy. Let's soften him up a little bit. Fuck you. And going for Bowie, that's not shocking at all. Four, we could live with four. Jahaz not able to close in, that's fine. Ooh, this guy, G, just got a fucking erection flying in there to attack Sarah. But she just eats that shit up, no problem. Let's go ahead and go for the archer, since he's about to die. Very good, very good. Wow, Chester. Jesus, we are just leveling up like nuts right now. And Bowie, let's go ahead and start working on this dude. Sarah can just heal herself. And Jaha, yes, let's finish this fucker off. I love it. Okay, let's see, how close are these assholes? Homeboy has 6 move. That's quite a significant amount. Let's put Kazen right here. Because the huge bat... Okay, perfect. And the huge bat is not in range to attack. So that worked out great. We drew in the Galam... What is he? Soldier, right? Yeah, Galam soldier. Drew him in without the huge bat coming in to help him. Chester, go ahead and throw your spear in his asshole. And Kazen. Show off some more of that blaze, bro. Very nice, very nice. Let's have Sarah heal Kazen, of course. Gotta keep him in tip-top shape. Considering he is the squishiest among us right now. Okay, guys, we made some pretty good progress. We went through this. Jesus, this is the third battle we've done just in the last half hour. I'll see you guys next time. We'll finish this battle off. Later!